it is important that you practice these 7 simple pranayams along with 7 main yogasanas: Mandukasan, Sasakasan, Bhujangasan, Shalabhasan, Uttanapadasan, Lokasan, Pavanmuktasan and Markatasan. Practice of these is adequate even then. Today, we are going to tell you some easy yogasanas and some small exercises for different diseases. In my opinion, you will certainly benefit by practice of these specifically for the problems from which you suffer. First of all, practice small exercises. Stretch your legs in front, hands on the floor, on either sides of your waist, back upright. The practice of the small exercises always begins with the feet. Press your toes in forward and backward directions. The practice of small exercises has proved beneficial, especially in joint pain. Patients having joint pain, those with an inflexible and a very stiff body may gain. Before you start practicing asanas, your body should be very flexible. And for this, what could be better than the practice of small exercises? Press your toes in forward and backward directions with all your force. The first exercise, press your fingers in forward and backward directions. It is good for your toes. Then similarly press all your toes also. Initially practice each exercise 3 times. Then gradually you may increase it to 10 to 15 times. Those suffering from joint pain should practice these small exercises initially for few days. As a result, their bodies will become flexible for yogasana. After pressing toes in forward and backward directions, bring your feet together, toes together and move them in circular direction. Knees should be straight. Move them in right to left, forward and backward, and in circular direction. Your feet is moving in a circular motion. After you are done in one direction, practice in the opposite direction. This will be effective in relieving pain of your heels and ankles also. Those suffering from cramps, varicose veins and filaria, do these small exercises along with Kapalabhati and Anulom Vilom Pranayam. They will benefit a lot. Now next exercise, specifically for the knees, feet together. Now stretch your knees and then relax them. While stretching the knees, you may feel a pressure on them. Whereas while relaxing, your knees will again become normal. This may improve your blood circulation. Relax your knees and then stretch. The next exercise is an essential exercise for your knees. Rest both of your hands below your thigh, your right thigh. Fingers should be interlocked. And then lift your right leg. Fold from the knee and again straighten. Move your leg in this fashion in circular direction and then from the opposite direction. First fold your leg, then lift it, afterwards stretch it as much as you can. So moving your leg in circular direction in front is a complete exercise for your knees. Repeat the same steps for the left knee. Rest both the hands below the thigh of the left leg, fingers in an interlocked position. This is a complete exercise for knees. Move your leg in circular direction from opposite direction also. Lift your leg, fold it and then straighten it. Then from opposite direction also fold your leg, lift it and straighten it. This is an essential exercise for your knees. Now one more important exercise for knees and hip joint. Fold your right leg and rest the foot over the left thigh. Rest your right foot over the thigh of your left leg. Right hand should rest over the knee of the right leg and left hand over the toes of right foot. Now while inhaling, shift your hand below the knee and slowly raise your knee to touch your chest. And then slowly shift your palm above the knee and bring it back to the same position while pressing the knee slightly. Again lift your knee. While lifting, palm should rest below the knee and while pressing down, keep your palm above the knee and press it down. So this is a small and an important exercise which will give relief from the pains of hip joint and also the knees. Now repeat the same steps for left leg. Fold the leg and rest it over the thigh of right leg. Rest your left hand over left knee, right hand over the toes of right foot. While raising the folded leg, rest your palm below the knee and while pressing it down, keep your palms above the knee.